What's up, guys? This is Alan. In today's episode, I'm going to be giving you the five top trees to have as a beginner gardener. Yes, if you're just starting growing plants, especially fruit trees, in today's episode, I'm going to be telling you the five top trees, bulletproof trees, that you can grow. These trees are so easy to grow that if you kill them, well, you need to pick a different hobby. So let's go ahead and get started. And that brings us to choice number one, and that is going to be mulberry trees. This tree right here is a Shangri-La mulberry, extremely easy to grow. It will take the full sun anywhere in the United States. It takes the full sun right here in the desert, and it doesn't get any hotter than in the desert. So it will take full sun in your area, and also they are very cold hardy. This tree is right here, it depends on the variety. Some varieties can take more cold than others, so you're gonna have to do your own research. But I hear people all the time in the comment section saying that they're growing mulberry trees in zone 5. But yeah, this tree is right here, they have a top root system, they grow super fast once rooted in the ground, they can reach the water deep below the ground, reach the nutrients deep below the ground, that to be honest, unless you're living in an extreme environment like mine over here, all you need to do is just water it for the first summer. Once rooted in the ground, they can take care of themselves. It hardly ever rains in my area. I have clay soil over here, but as long as your soil drains the water, and I know you get more water than I do here in the desert, your mulberry tree will grow. This right here, I always tell people, if you buy a mulberry and you kill it, you automatically go in the hole of shame. Yes, I have a hole of shame. I have five people in the hole of shame that I know personally in the past 7 years that actually have killed mulberry trees. The next tree on the list, it's gonna be figs. Yes, this tree's right here, just like the mulberry trees, are extremely easy to grow. They can take full sun anywhere in the United States. They can take cold. Some varieties can take more cold than others. They may not be as cold hardy as mulberry trees, but I can tell you a lot of people in the United States should be able to grow a fig in the ground. And if you don't want to grow it in the ground, you can grow them in containers. But keep in mind, figs in containers don't really grow that fast, they don't really grow that well, and they don't hold fruits as well. But if you're happy with just a few fruits every once in a while, and you're happy with this type of growth right here, then you should be able to grow them in containers. Fig trees are so easy to grow that just like mulberry trees, if you kill it, you tried killing it. Because once you put them in the ground, they can literally take care of themselves. They have an extremely vigorous, invasive root system. Their roots, as soon as they touch the ground, they spread and they go deep into the ground. And that's what makes these trees very strong and easy to grow. Full sun, no winter protection in most areas. And usually if you have them from cuttings or grafted, they readily fruit. And they come in many, many different varieties. Here on my property, I probably have easily over 15 fig varieties planted in the ground, and they are all different sizes, shapes. And one thing that most people don't realize is figs do not taste the same from the store as the ones that you actually pick from your own tree. You know why? Because they have no shelf life. Once these figs right here are ready to eat, they will drop, and then you can pick them and you can eat them. But usually the ones at the stores, they pick them green when they're hard like this for shipping, because otherwise they will get squished and the flavor is not there. When you counter ripen your figs, they are not going to taste the same as a fresh fig picked from the tree. I've had many people tell me they do not like figs, but as soon as they eat my figs, well, guess what? They change their minds. And that brings us to number three, and that is going to be pomegranate trees. If you've been following me for a while, you guys have actually seen these trees being replanted from the front yard into the backyard of my house, simply because the area they were in, they were not doing that well. And as you can see, they're doing amazing. They're huge and they are flowering and they got fruits ripening right now. Pomegranate trees take full sun anywhere in the United States, and a lot of varieties, they can take a lot of cold, a lot. And guess what? They produce tons of fruits. They're so easy to grow. I mean, come on, guys. If you kill it, you tried killing it. But anyways, like I said, extremely easy to grow. Most pomegranates out there are grown from cuttings, and they readily fruit the same year or the following year. And just like figs, they have a very deep root system that goes straight down in the ground. It spreads, making the tree very strong. And that's the reason why this tree is on the top five. Next tree on the list is going to be jujube. I haven't talked about this tree in the past because, I don't know, I think they're boring. Because they're that easy to grow. And that's the reason why this tree is on this list. This tree right here will take full sun anywhere in the United States. It will take cold. I've done my research and I've seen people online say that you can grow this tree right here all the way down to zone 5. That is cold, guys. One of the things about the jujube is in cooler areas, you're gonna have to make sure to protect it for the first couple of years until your tree actually gets older and it gets bark on its trunk, because the bark is gonna insulate it in the winter time. And in cooler areas where the soil completely freezes solid, well, that's gonna help it along. Another thing to do with the jujube in cooler areas is just mulch the area heavily. I'm talking about like 1-2 feet all the way around the canopy of the tree, so that way that area does not freeze. But there are many different varieties out there, and each variety is gonna be a little bit different. But jujubes taste amazing, they grow super fast. It's gonna be a really nice shade tree. One of the things I do not like about the jujube though is that it's got thorns, and the thorns will mess you up. Yeah, they're very, you know, they get small, they get big, it just depends on the variety. But that's the only thing I don't like about it. And the other thing I don't like about jujube is it will shoot suckers. You see, this is the main tree right here. But if we walk this way over here, I got a sucker jujube growing over here. Look. Jujube right here. So I gotta dig this guy up. Look at the thorns. Those will mess you up. So, but anyways, yeah. So that's the only thing you gotta worry about the jujube. They will shoot suckers everywhere. It's not like it's hard to maintain. You just find them like that, dig them up, cut them off. Whatever you gotta do, just do it. Chili, where you at? Chili, are you running, Chili? Are you gonna tell these people what the next tree is gonna be? Are you gonna tell them? So which one is it, Chili? Huh? Which one is it? Is it that one over there? That one? That one? Okay, I'm gonna tell them, yes. The next tree on the list is gonna be stump fruits. If you don't know what a stump fruit is, it's a fruit that has a big pit in the middle, and hence the name stump fruit. Who came up with that? I have no idea. But we're talking about peaches, nectarines, plums, apricots. So I got a bunch of trees in here. I got a peach over there. I got an apricot, a plum, and some other hybrid. But anyways, this tree right here will grow anywhere in the United States. Now, this tree falls under the category of chill hours. What is a chill hour? It's 1 hour in the winter when the temperature is 45 degrees or below for at least 1 hour. Certain varieties in the stump fruit family require a certain amount of chill hours every winter to produce well. Now, that does not mean if you don't have the enough chill hours, the tree is not gonna grow or it's not gonna fruit. It's still gonna grow, it's still going to fruit, but it's not going to be as productive. Like here in the desert, stone fruits mainly grow in cooler areas, but there are certain varieties in my area that have lower chill hours, like kissed apricot over there. I think that one has 300 chill hours. In my area, my specific area, I get about, I would say between 300 to 500 hours, if not more, some years. As you can see, they're ripening. So I do get a lot of fruit in my area. But you know what? In warmer climates, you don't get that cold that long in the wintertime. So these trees are still gonna grow, but your fruit production may not be the greatest. Now in cooler areas, this is gonna be your trees of choice, because you guys in cooler areas, you are out of luck. You are stuck with boring trees. I'm playing. They're not boring, but you know what? Peaches, plums, nectarines, they have their place, but they're not as fun as growing tropical plants like a mango or something else like that. But you know what? If you want to grow fruit trees, this is going to be the choice for you. Easy to grow. They take full sun anywhere in the United States. They are deciduous trees, meaning they drop their leaves in the winter and go bare. And they wake up in the spring. The only problem that I had, you're going to have with these trees in cooler environment is, well, if they flower and you get a late freeze, even though the trees will take the cold, the flowers will not, and you will lose your crop. So that's the only bad thing about the stone fruits. And just like every other tree that I listed in this video, these trees have a taproot system and it grows straight down in the ground. If you are a beginner gardener and you're looking for easy to grow trees, and maybe the trees that I listed in this video you don't like and you want something else, my recommendation for you is to look for trees that have a taproot system. If you don't know what a taproot is, well, it is a tree that has usually one root or maybe a few roots, and they grow straight down in the ground and they're thick. And those trees usually are going to be a lot stronger than shallow rooted plants. So if you're looking for fruit trees, always look for trees that have deep roots, vigorous, invasive roots, tap roots, because those trees are always gonna do a lot better. And even if you neglect them, they can fend for themselves once you put them in the ground. This is another mulberry over here. This is the green mulberry. And one thing I like about mulberry trees, you can see all this shade in here, guys. I am in the freaking desert. It's hot here. This heat, if you don't drink water, will kill you. But look at this environment right here. Look how peaceful it is. It is probably about 20 degrees cooler out here than it is out there in the sun. Look all this shade. The birds singing. How peaceful this is. Imagine having a bad day at work, long day, working your ass off nonstop to pay your bills, and then coming home and then sitting down underneath your fruit trees that you planted, that you are taking care of, and seeing your hard work paying off. And that brings us to bonus fruit tree. And that's going to be apple trees, guys. Now, this do not fall under the stump fruits, but you know what? Most apple varieties out there do better in cooler environments. You guys in colder areas are going to have more selection than I do here in the desert, because just like the stump fruits, apple trees require a certain amount of chill hours in order to produce well. So I think this one, I forget what it is. It's either a Golden Delicious or Golden Dorset. As you can see, you got apples everywhere. My apples usually ripen in the summer. And my tree is loaded. Last year, my tree was so loaded that my branches were breaking. So, but apples are extremely easy to grow, full sun anywhere in the United States, no winter protection, and they have a taproot system. It grows straight down in the ground. Easy to grow, and most varieties are going to be grafted. So whenever you buy a tree, make sure you keep the suckers off, because otherwise they will take the grafted part of the tree. Now, I know some of you guys are not gonna agree with my stone fruits pick for this video, because a lot of you guys kill them, and then you automatically think that they are hard to grow and it's the tree's fault. No, it's not the tree's fault. It is your fault while you're killing them. I go into details why these trees die most times in this video right here. But just as a quick summary, a lot of the stump fruits and apples, they usually come bird root. A lot of the nurseries just put them in containers and then sell them to you without the trees being fully rooted in those containers. When the trees wake up, they will react to whatever damage those trees sustained during the wintertime when they were dormant. And that's the main reason why these trees die. It's not because you didn't water them. It's not because you forgot to put the sulfur in there or the azomite or the fish emulsion. It is because these trees were so damaged during the wintertime when they were dormant that they died when they woke up. And like I said, I go into details about this. So go ahead and watch that video. If you have any questions, any comments, comment below. And I will see you next time. Chili, are you laying down? Is a chili laying down? All right, guys, I got to show you this. Look at Chili. Chili is exhausted. Yes, Chili wants a break. He's tired of being out here in the heat. He's too spoiled. He wants to go in the AC. But you know what's funny? When I go in the AC in the house and then I come back out, he wants to come out again. He cannot make his mind up. He doesn't want to be in the heat, but he doesn't want to be in the house alone. And this is why I love doggies.